quote, become a better man and player because of this experience. So, Shannon, what percentage of the blame is on Haskins for how things ended here?
Skip, they say that you can only do when people make your fun. Like, I'm going to give 110%, 120%, 1,000%. Well, considering that 100 is as high as you can go, he's 100% of the blame for what happened to Dwayne Haskins. Skip, we talked about it earlier segment. Production and tolerance. As long as production is high, tolerance will be high. And then they will tolerate you until they can replace you. Dwayne Haskins did not build up the field cachet. He wasn't playing like Patrick Mahomes. He wasn't playing like Deshaun Watson to go and get caught in a misgiving like that. And I get it, Skip. Oh, he went number. But you have to understand where we are in 2020, today's society, with what's going on. That in and of itself, plus you couple the fact, man, my head coach just did 8 weeks of chemo. Man, his immune system. Man, I can't put him in a situation like that. My teammates are counting on me. That's why they say football is the hardest sport to win a championship in, Skip, because one guy could upset, blow the whole thing up.
Yep.
So he's 100% responsible. And then the reports are coming out, his study habits, his practice habits, I've seen it before. Every coach I've ever had, from Dan Reeves to Wade Phillips to Mike Shanahan to Brian Billick, they all told us the same thing. Let us cut you. Don't you cut yourself. Skip, I was with a guy, Skip. They asked me, we'd be sitting in the meeting. Such and such, what you got on this play? Huh? Huh means he was asleep. Because Skip, they used to have, hey, Sean, what you 84? What you got on this? What you got on this? I can just spit it off. I'm paying attention. I say, bruh, now, if you don't stop this, they're going to cut you. Simple as that. Man, Sharp, they're not playing me. I need to be playing, man. You know. I said, bro, I'm telling you now. I've been at this a long time. I say, you not producing. All you doing is playing scout team, and you're sleeping in the meeting. I come over there one Tuesday, Skip, to get my workout in. Man, they got your boy, Sharp, hey. You were right. You right. Dwayne Haskins, how long you thought they was going to let this keep going? That you could do your behavior off the field, coupled with your performance on the field. How long did you think they were going to let this happen? Bruh, you are a professional. This ain't Ohio State. You play for college tuition if you have kids. You play for mortgages, not housing, not books. You play for future. And you, Skip, does he understand there's always going to be a time for you to go to the club? Skip, I'm 50 if I want to go to 52. If I want to go to every night, I can do that. But not when I'm playing. I'm going to make that money. I ain't giving none of them no money back. I'm not going to be late for a meeting. You're not going to find me for nothing. He doesn't get it. Hopefully, he gets another opportunity, and he'll learn from this mistake. But let this not only him, but let others see. Bruh, they mean business. And if your production doesn't match the tolerance level, they're going to get you up out of there. It's as simple as that. It is, ain't no black. He went to the, if he was in a better situation, he was in a great situation. He chose to do other things. Other things were more important than football. So now he gets an opportunity. He goes to strip club every day. What you want to bet, Skip? He ain't at the strip club every night now. I bet he ain't there every night. Because pretty soon the money going to run through. The money going to jump funny. And you'll see. But hopefully he gets an opportunity.
Yep.
Hopefully he learned his lesson. Hopefully others see this, learn their lesson. And we won't, but it won't, it ain't going to happen to me.
Okay, I hear everything you just said. And when it comes to dedication to an opportunity that you were given, I have little to no sympathy for what he didn't do, because he didn't dedicate himself. And these jobs, they're precious.
Give me only 32 of them. He had a starting job.
And someday he'll wake up. Someday, I don't know how long it'll take, 10 years, 20 years,
today.
30 years, maybe. But he'll look back at some point and say, I had the opportunity of a lifetime, and you just, they don't come along very often, and you just have to maximize it.
You do.
Okay. So yet in the end, I'm only going to give him 50% of the blame. The reason being, when it comes to quarterback, it's a different animal than the guys, the other teammates you're telling you got to be dedicated. You got to give it your all.
Yes.
Sometimes it doesn't matter if you're giving your all at quarterback, because a lot of times it boils down to you can either play it or you can't play it. And again, I'm not being 20/20 hindsight on this. I said before he was drafted, I just couldn't see him as a first round pick.
Right.
Well, I think a whole lot of people couldn't see him as a first round pick.
Only one person.
Except one person did. And he's not a scout. He's not a GM. He's not a personnel director. He owns the Washington football team.
Yes.
And he's had a history of this with Robert Griffin III. He had a history of this.
I love that kid.
I love him. I want to live with that kid. I want him to come to my office every day. Robert's tremendous. He's got great charisma, and he wanted RG3. And then
Mike didn't have a skill. Mike didn't have a problem, but he says, Dan, we in salary cap hell. You just had to pay 30 because Skip, remember, they tried to put all the money in that 1 year. Mm-hmm. So they ended up losing $38 million in cap space. Mike was trying to explain to him, if you trade up all your draft capital to get this young man, how do you build a roster when you can't sign free agency, when you're $38 million less in cap space, mm-hmm, and you have no capital? And
Mike Shanahan, your coach, was right. the coach there.
He's like, I like him too. He said, but if you give up this.
Yep, got it. Okay, so in this case, it didn't require trading up to the top of the draft. It just required sitting right there at 15
right,
and saying, we'll take him.
Right.
I assume it played a big part in this, that Dwayne Haskins starred at a Washington, D.C. area, mm-hmm, high school, right, at which now the son of Dan Snyder now attends.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So there's a connection there. Son loves it. You know, he's captivating.
Right.
Brought him in for an interview. Oh, I love this kid. You know, he'd be great around here. Can he play? Because that's all that really matters.
Yeah.
So the reason I can't completely condemn Dwayne Haskins is I don't think he was good enough to live up to the hype and the expectations to begin with.
You could be right, Skip. But, Skip, when we're growing up, man, if I get an opportunity, not one time says, if I get that opportunity, I'm going to mess it up.
Okay.
You always think, Skip, I'm going to do, man, or I'm going to go on time, I'm going to do my, Skip, we don't know if he might can't play, but how about study? How about practice hard?
I got it, but it's so different. Like James Harrison just said on our show, hey, it's hard to be an undrafted free agent and make it, but he made it on defense, defensive end, pass rusher.
Right.
Where you can do it on effort. You can do it on desire.
Well, he started out on special teams.
He did.
The quarterbacks ain't going to play no special teams.
Well, that's what I'm
saying.
He
either play a quarterback or that's it. I made it on special teams, Skip, before I got to play receiver.
It's hard to just try hard and be a great quarterback because it's hard to overachieve. You can for a couple of weeks, 3 or 4 weeks.
Right.
You've seen they'll come and they'll go. They'll have flashes. Mm-hmm. They're 15 minutes of fame. But in this case, I just don't think he was good enough to live up to the 15th overall pick, and then you get thrown into the fire, and all of a sudden you got a coaching change, and Ron Rivera comes in. He gave him the shot for the first four games this year. Nope, he wasn't good enough.
I'll give you a prime example. Chase Daniels has made $38 million.
Yep.
But you know what he does? He practices hard.
Definitely.
He studies hard. He comes on time. Skip, he couldn't play dead in the Western.
Nope. Mm-hmm.
But somehow he's managed to stay he stayed like almost 10 years with 5, 6, 7 different teams.
Mostly as a backup.
Mostly as a backup. Mm-hmm. You mean to tell me he can't fool them long enough to play backup and make him $30, $40 million?
No, sure, that's all another issue.
Yes!
He can't go forward.
Yes! Yep.
I'll buy that because he's got a big arm. He's got a much bigger arm than Chase.
Yes! Skip, all you got to do, Skip, just come. I'm going to fool him.
Yep.
I'm going to come here and take my notes, practice hard.
Mm.
He going to go out there and going to.
Okay, I got it.
Well, mess off his money.
And sometimes going to your hometown team can be
only
harder
LeBron
than you expect.
Your homeboy, hey, homeboy,
but
come on through.
Hopefully his tweet is real. He's going to learn from this experience, and that's really all we can say about Dwayne Haskins right now. I want to transition to James Harden. Is he changing his mind about his trade demand to leave the Rockets? We've got some interesting quotes for you after the break. Now America.